There is not a human being on this planet that goes through life feeling up 100% of the time. There is not a human being alive on this planet who is happy 100% of the time. We all have low moments. We all suffer setbacks. We all get caught up in things we shouldn't. And we all lose our way. Some of us remain lost forever. And some of us find our way back to the path we were destined to travel. Eckhart Tolle once said, "The primary cause of unhappiness is never the situation, but your thoughts about it." Whether you stay lost or find that path is a choice. If you beat yourself down or lift yourself up, it is a choice. And that choice starts in your own mind. Your reality is not what has happened, but how you frame what has happened. Change your thoughts, and you will change your life. Here are 5 ways to get back on track whenever you've lost your way. Number 1, write down your reason why. When you know your reason why, you need no external motivators. Why must you do what you do? Why must you succeed? Why must you get healthy, develop yourself, set a positive example? Why must you earn money, change your attitude, strengthen your relationships? Who are you doing it for? Why must you keep fighting? There is a reason. And when you find that reason, it will light a fire under everything you do. It will get you up early and keep you up late. It will inspire you to push harder, to fight longer, to try a different way, to find a way, to never, ever give up. You'll still have low moments, but you'll never stay there. Find that reason. Number 2, know that life is short. Understanding at a deep level that life is short and you only get one shot at this human experience can be one of the most powerful ways to get you back on track. It's not a recipe for recklessness or craziness. It's a knowing that life is short and everything you are stressing about will likely not matter in the end. It takes the heaviness off almost every problem. Let it go. And focus on doing the things you love, following your passions, surrounding yourself with great people. Be grateful for the life you have inside you, the time you have left, and make the most of that time. Ask yourself, how do I want to be remembered? How can I conduct myself today and every other day so I am remembered that way? Number 3. Feed your mind with something positive and powerful. Consume as much positive, transformative, and powerful self-development material as possible. However you do it, books, audio, videos, mentors, it doesn't matter how. It only matters that you do. If you are feeding your mind with powerful content every day and really taking it in, it is very unlikely you will lose your way. You lose your way by getting caught up in the negative, like most people on this planet. Negative news, petty conflicts, comparison with others. You find your way by doing what most people don't. And one of those things is self-development. Be curious and open with your self-development. Seek to learn, grow, and develop yourself in all areas of your life. Ask yourself what you would love to improve in your life with your personal skills or traits and seek the best mentors and skills on those topics. You can also feed your mind with your own inner content. This is known as gratitude. There is no more powerful force on earth than gratitude. And if you are really feeling it deep and practicing it every day, it will ensure you remain in a powerful, positive state. Number 4, move. Science has proven physical exercise can lower depression, reduce stress, and release endorphins, or happy chemicals, from your brain. So next time you lose your way, get to the gym, go for a run, sweat, release that tension somewhere positive. Do it daily and continue to grow your physical strength. Your physiology and posture also has a lot to do with how you feel. You will feel very different by standing tall with your shoulders back and putting a big cheesy grin on your face than you will slumped over, shoulders down, and frowning. Take note of your posture when you are down. Be conscious of it. Learn all you can about it and make the needed changes. Number 5, know where you want to go. Goals are important because they clearly define where you want to go and keep you on track to getting there. Science and common sense will tell you those who set specific and clearly defined goals are much more likely to live successful and fulfilled lives than those who don't. Here's a few secrets to goal setting. Firstly, be very specific about what you want. If it's money, don't just write down, "I want more money." Write exactly how much money. If it's a fitness goal, don't just write, "I want a better body." Write the exact weight or body fat measurement you must reach. Second, be clear about when you must have it. "I will make $1 million per year by the 31st of December, 2019. I will reach 10% body fat by the 30th of June, 2019. Finally, define how you will reach that goal. "I will make $1 million per year by the 31st of December, 2019, doing X. And to do that, I will first need to learn Y and complete Z." By getting clear about what you must have and defining how you will get it and by when, you will now have a clear purpose to work toward. The chances of you getting off track when you have something important to work towards is very slim. The key is to make it meaningful to you. We gave a money example, but your goals should never really be centered around money, unless that money goal is attached to a greater purpose, your reason for making that money, which might be children, family, or a cause you believe in. Now you know how to get back on track. Now you know that there are ways to get back on track. You don't have to stay lost. You know, next time, this too shall pass. It will pass. Keep going, and keep growing.